brilliant, sensational week and a geared up for a long weekend. We have a long weekend coming. Yay! Lots of riding. Hope the weather is good. And for you eventers out there, good luck at Melbourne Free Day. That is all I think I needed to say for my intro. So where are we? Question. We had a question from Hayley, and today the question was... Just let me access my information. It was about, she rides thoroughbred, and horses really cool, calm, collected, out on the road, it's all fine, dogs and rubbish bins and everything's fine. But then some horses started cantering around in a paddock, which riled him up and maybe reminded him about his previous life when he used to be a racehorse. And she really struggled to get his attention, and he actually became, I don't like the word dangerous, but yeah, he was hot, really hot. And you know when a horse is like not thinking, they're a bit scary, like they go through walls and bolt and kill themselves. So I'm guessing is the scenario that happened. I'm reading between the lines of your question there, Hayley. But yeah, so the question I think, with what you're asking, is there anything you can do when your horse becomes hot or anything you can do to calm him down? So firstly, yay, congratulations for asking a Frisian rider this. but there is a reason why I do like kind of the colder breeds. I'm not good with hot. Having said that, I actually own some Frisians that are super hot. So I've learned to deal with it. And also just coming at it from a perspective of a trainer or coming up from a perspective of like using NLP, it's like, okay, cool, there are some things that we can try. Because even if you have experience or don't, you can still address situations from a logical perspective, hopefully. So, firstly, what do you do when your horse becomes really, really hot? So, I really like when my horses are really, so I ride stallions, so they really puff themselves up and you're like, oh, please don't breathe. Please just don't go jump on some horse. Because you do realise a 700 kilo stallion is a little bit stronger than me, just a little bit. But I have to make sure that he doesn't know that, because if he does, he's going to go crazy and I'm going to get banned from competition, basically. So I have to make him believe that I'm stronger than him, and I have to control the situation. So what I do is I put the horse in a shoulder in. So if they're looking at there, over there, they're in shoulder in left, going to test me left with less than right. And if they're looking over to the left, they're going to go in shoulder in right. So they're going to want to look. So when the horse's head comes up and they want to look, my horse's head goes down and you're not looking. So that's my way of controlling the situation and my way of saying, whatever you want to do, buddy, has nothing to do with what I want to do and what I'm going to get you to do. So you control the situation that way. And then you've got to have them not just in shoulder in. So if you start getting really handy, especially on a thoroughbred, when I used to ride thoroughbreds, if you do too much with the hands, they just, to me, get even hotter and canter on the spot, and they're just going up and down and you're like, oh, not fun. So you have to make sure you're putting them in shoulder in, but you're giving. So this is really where it steps up to you as the rider to not have to control every single millisecond. So control every second millisecond would be my advice. So I'm in shoulder in and I'll soften. And I'm really saying, you're doing this and I'm allowing. You're doing this and I'm allowing. And every time I allow, the head goes to go up and the head goes to fling over there. But I've only given for a millisecond, so in that next millisecond, get your head down and get through. Because what you're trying to do is get them back into their dressage, through into the bridle. It's like a puppy dog lying on its back, exposing its stomach. That's what submission is. So if you can get your horse submissive the other way, which is through over the back and down into the bridle, doesn't matter what's going on around him, you've got him. So you've got to make sure you're not just hauling on their mouth. And I get when your horse is about to bolt, or your horse is about to rear, or your horse is just jumping up and down, you're just like, oh my God, I don't want to die. And the adrenaline's going and everything's going, but you've got to soften. You've got to believe that perhaps in this millisecond that they're going to be okay. So there's a trust. So you've got to give, take, give, take, give, take. And I'm not saying give, take. It's not that slow. It is literally in a millisecond you've given, taken three times. So the horse doesn't feel held because there's that moment of softening and then giving and then softening, take, softening, take, softening, take. So the horse isn't stressed out, but it feels contained and making itself even worse. But at the same time, you're saying, I don't care what you're doing, you've got to start focusing on me. Then you've also got to have really, really good skills as a rider, because you're going to put them in shoulder in, and I'm just imagining that I'm on this crazy thoroughbred. The next thing it's going to do is just go and kind of like do a half pass, side pass thing to try and get out of my shoulder in. So I'll put its head this way, so it's going to go fine. I'm running sideways like a crab that way. So you've got to block with your outside rein and outside leg to really say no. So you, to me, my legs are my fence, my outside legs are fence, my inside leg is a fence. You can't go through either. You can't fall to the inside because there's a fence there. You can't fall to the outside because there's a fence there. So you've got to get really, really tricky and really, really skilled. So if you feel the horse try to expand and try, so the hot horse is going, well, I can't run out that way, I'm going to run out the side. Then straight away you go, no, the leg's there, and maybe you do a slight counterflexion to the outside just for a millisecond to say, haha, gotcha, I can't do that. And then he'll feel that and he'll go, fine, I'm gonna run out this way. And go, haha, gotcha, I can't do that. Inside leg, outside rein. So you're constantly playing with the dynamics of where they want to put their weight and basically blocking it, saying, okay, you want to throw your weight that way? Gotcha, you can't. And then you've thrown their weight the counter way, the other way. So they're going, fine, I'm gonna go there, throw it back the other way. And constantly just play with your horse's weight and controlling it so you are in control. Very, very easy to say in a house, can be really, really challenging to do. And you've got to have a lot of skill to be able to do it, to feel pretty much before the horse even knows what it's going to do, to block it being able to do it. What else can you do? There's a hormone that's released when the horse's poll is below the wither. It's meant to relax the horse. So if that's the whole other reason we go shoulder in and try and get that horse's neck down, if it's up, I don't care what horse it is. If the horse's head is up, it's a lot tenser than if the horse's head's down, submissive and working. So your whole thing is, no matter what is happening in your external world, you control your little bubble. So whenever I ride, I don't know if I've talked about this, but I live in a bubble. And me and my pony are just riding in our little bubble and everything's great. And I actually have no notions of the external world unless I'm in a warm-up ring and I have to be looking where I'm going and not cutting anyone off and staying, making sure left hand to left hand. Seriously, dude, like me in a warm-up ring, I'm like left, left, left hand. And I'm constantly wiggling my left brain to figure out, okay, that's my left hand, so that's gotta go left hand to left hand. No, I've gotten good at it, trust me. You guys just sometimes just be going, what? Sorry, I've had too much sugar this morning and I'm a little, Okay, back to focus. What are we talking about? External world, yeah. So you've got to make sure your external world isn't allowed to penetrate your internal world. So even though you're out on the roads and there's cars and there's a possibility of death and there's horses running around, your horse is going crazy, all you are in your little bubble going, okay, I've got to make sure that I get my horse's head down, and I've got to make sure that if he wants to bolt out the front, that he can't. If he wants to bolt out the side, he can't. If he wants to bolt out that side, he can't. If he wants to run backwards, my hands are forwards and kicking, so he must go forward. And constantly just managing this little Tetris model thing that can go sideways, backwards, because the horse can only do four things. Two sides, front, back. If you stop all of that, yeah, it can still go up, but just lean forward, you're okay. And the main thing is, don't get emotionally involved in what's happening. So if my horse is going ballistic, I become even more of the ice queen. So whatever is happening underneath me has nothing to do with me. I'm just completely a computer. Do you see how my state has changed? There's no laughing now. The state is, what you do has nothing to do with what I do or how I feel. And I'm just a computer taking in information and responding accordingly. So if you're running that way, I'm gonna make a response that's appropriate to the response that you've given me. And I'm very much a computer, very much have no emotions involved. Emotions are not allowed on a horse as far as I'm concerned. I joke and laugh all the time, and even in my warm-up I'm laughing and all that kind of stuff. But then it's gotta go. It's just, you're a stimulus response machine. Whatever you feel from the horse, you just respond accordingly. And when you can get there, then you're going to be in a much clearer state to respond to what's happening. I think that's it. Hope that's helped. Please let me know how that goes. I'd love to hear your feedback. And even if you said no, and if you tried it and maybe something else came about it and you want to ask another question, happy to help. Everybody, have a fantastic weekend and I'll talk to you soon. Bye.